This is a Sigma Stunner. It is an excellent light gun in its own right. Seeing what is connected to the cord might come as a surprise. I use it to play Super Nintendo Entertainment System games. I never bought a Nintendo Super Scope as for its lack of sights. I was thinking about putting the internals of a Super Scope into a gun frame in order to use it in a somewhat similar manner as a Sigma Menacer in its gun configuration. Luckily, I found the mod I'm introducing in this video when doing my research. Allow me to give a brief overview over the guns of the SNES to explain why this modification is relevant. The Super Scope looks like a bazooka. The player places it onto the shoulder, aims through the scope, and fires by pressing the colored trigger button, which is located at the top of the gun. Next to it are the pause button and the fire mode switch. At the front handle is the cursor button. As a rectangle, a black bar hangs into the side picture. The scope can either be attached to the left or right hand side of the gun, depending on the eye dominance of the player. The gun needs 6 AA cells. At the top of the lens, there is an infrared transmitter which communicates with a receiver located at the top of the television. It sends the gun inputs over the receiver to the connected console. Konami made a SNES version of its famous Justifier. The gun I'm holding here is actually the Mega Drive version. Sadly, the Justifier lacks sights. In order to play Snatcher, I finally ended up putting sights onto the gun myself. Besides the trigger, the gun has a start button. In the handle, there is a RJ12 socket, which allows the player to plug in a similar purple gun for the second player. Overall, the gun is well built. Besides the Super Scope and the Justifier, there were other guns for the SNES. The Top Fighter was a Justifier clone, which was compatible with both SNES and Mega Drive. I think this is a great idea considering the rather small library of Justifier compatible games. The Turbo Gun is a lovely Super Scope alternative. It resembles the PlayChoice 10 gun, the Konami Justifier, and the American Laser Games game gun patterns, but has distinctive differences. Just like the Super Scope, it has buttons for pause and cursor. The back side is used as a fire mode switch. A very interesting gun was used by the US Army for target practice. The project was called MAX, which stood for Multi-Purpose Arcade Combat Simulator, and used Jaeger AP-74 rifles turned into light guns. Sadly, besides the Turbo Gun, all those guns are incompatible to the Super Scope. Furthermore, the Turbo Gun is rare, and thus hard to get. Luckily, Micro, an active member of the CircuitBoard.de community, invented a Sigma Stunner to SNES conversion. This is a scheme of his modification. A CMOS 8-stage static shift register is added into the gun. It is connected to the original Stunner PCB and to the SNES controller pins. Micro suggests gluing the chip onto the already present IC. These are the internals of the gun. Personally, I added 35 grams weights into each RAID slot in order to relocate the gun's center of mass. This is a converted Sigma Stunner. The screw heads are not related to the conversion itself. They hold a cherry switch in place, which is inside the gun because I removed the old trigger switch. The original start button now acts as the cursor button. Next to it is the pause button. Instead of a toggle switch, I use a latching button, which I placed inside the fake safety handle. The plastic of my particular stunner was very brittle. Therefore, I recommend grinding the holes instead of drilling them. I repaired broken screw pads with air drying putty. This is the stunner in action. A good test game is the Mario-themed light gun game Yoshi's Safari, as it supports all buttons and the fire mode switch. This video is dedicated to DBN Poldermans, who enjoys hardware modifications. My acknowledgement goes to Micro. Thank you very much for sharing this outstanding modification with us. A link to his original YouTube video covering this gun is located in the video description box. Also, I want to acknowledge Flatus Walrus, 98 Pacecar, Maximus Clean, and U272945 for giving me the permission to use their photographs. My special thanks go to Marvelous10, who made amazing photos of the turbo gun just for this video. This is the end of the review. My name is Ben. I thank you for viewing.